what does GoodRx offer that Amazon doesn't? I mean, how is GoodRx going to compete with Amazon?
Sure. I think the conversation's being set up as if we're competitors, and I'm not actually sure that's the right comparison. What Amazon did yesterday was they launched an updated version of PillPack, which is their online pharmacy they've owned since 2018, which is great. They're trying to get more Americans to buy prescriptions online. Unfortunately, only about 5% of prescriptions are actually mail order, and it's not even accelerating much in COVID. Meanwhile, we have a program called GoodRx Gold, which actually has lower prices about 90% of the time. They also added a discount card, which hundreds of other companies have been doing for years. I mean, honestly, for decades before we even came along. But it's not even a priority for them. It's very hard to find. And you can always imagine how weird it would be if I showed an Amazon discount card at a Walmart pharmacy. I suspect that probably won't actually be something that lasts for very long. In short, we actually don't think it'll impact us much, but I think investors or whoever are seeing, you know, are seeing news about Amazon and pharmacy and somehow assuming it'll impact us. I'm really excited about the stuff we're working on and some of our new initiatives that are growing super fast, but I guess the news is all about something else right now.
Doug, are you saying that you don't consider Amazon pharmacy a competitor?
I think that Amazon certainly has products, which maybe somewhere down the road we might have conflicting agendas. But actually, right now, GoodRx actually partners with Amazon, and oftentimes GoodRx discounts can be used at Amazon pharmacy. GoodRx actually partners with people throughout the healthcare ecosystem. Everyone, pharmacies, manufacturers, physicians. We're actually we're sort of Switzerland, if you can think of it that way. And we just work with whoever will help us get Americans the healthcare they need at a price they can afford. So, you know, this kind of us versus Amazon fight is, I don't think, actually the right way to portray this. We work closely together, and we don't think it'll have a material impact on our business in the short term.
Okay, so you don't seem to be concerned about Amazon, but investors are concerned. JP Morgan slapped a sell rating on GoodRx this morning following this news. This is, of course, after your huge September IPO. And analysts were already at that time kind of split on the stock. What do you say to the skeptics?
You know, I think pharmacy is really confusing. And throughout our history, remember, it's been almost a decade that GoodRx has been in existence. People have told us that, you know, no, we don't understand, or this is how the industry works. The reality is it's quite confusing. It's really hard. There's very few people who get, you know, knee deep in the complex economics of pharmacy. I'm very confident of our position. We've been doing this for a long time. We have incredibly smart people that work here. We're very close with people in the industry. And I think we have a superior product. We've saved Americans $25 billion. We have, you know, almost 5 million people a month use GoodRx to save. We know so much about this very obscure, you know, complicated industry. And I'm very proud of the products that we offer that I think, frankly, are far better than any out there.